Oh, howdy there, and welcome to another exciting episode of Forensic Folders. I'm your host, William Locard, descendant of the famous Edwin Locard, father of criminalistics. Today's episode is all about the different kinds of evidence that can be collected and associated with a crime. Now, I must remind you that what you're about to see are reenactments and under no circumstances should be performed at home. And I should also note that there is absolutely no prolonged sexual tension between any of our characters. If that's what you're into, change your channel now to Grey's Anatomy or CSI. Thank you very much. Sit back and enjoy the show.
It's done. Lights? My beauty serum is complete. Now the name of Neff will live forever. Lights.
Freeze.
Put the serum down.
You got any twos? Yeah, who am I kidding? You're only a dog. Hello, Agent Z speaking. Yes, I know Miss Neff. She's been shot? What, shot a dirty look? Shot with Cupid's arrow? Shot dead? Oh my God, I'll be there immediately.
The first step a good CSI should take is to properly secure the scene.
Secured, then the CSI's work really begins.
There are many things to do. Sketch the scene, take notes, take pictures, and collect evidence. Agent A and I will be using the grid method to search for and collect evidence. Let's get started.
This is our first piece of evidence. Blood spatter on the wall. This is pattern evidence. Because of its pattern, we can tell where it came from. Agent Q, make sure you get a picture of this and make a sketch of it in the drawing. Agent Z, take a small sample of this so we can possibly get later identification.
Look what we have here. Seems to be fingerprints. Agent A, hand me your flashlight so I can get a better look. Yep, those are prints all right. A fingerprint is transfer evidence because it's transferred from one object to another. In this case, from a person's hand to the counter. I'll dust these prints and lift them for possible suspect identification. There we are. Perfect prints. I'll run these through APHIS later. That's the Automatic Fingerprint Identification System. It can match these prints to any number of criminals.
Man, she's been Chris Brown.
Too soon.
Hey guys, look what I found. It says boo.
Looks like Mrs. Neff has been booed for the last time.
This note is a great example of associative evidence. You can link the handwriting to the suspect of a crime.
Hey, you guys smell that?
Yes, it's the smell of roses. It's unusual, but it won't last for long. That's why it's a transient evidence. It fades away. Luckily, I've made a note of it already.
Good work, Agent Q, but I think you missed something. Notice how all the materials on the lab bench have been knocked over? This shows that there was a struggle here, and that's conditional evidence.
I'm way ahead of you. I've taken pictures and I've marked disturbances of the lab table.
Agent Q, you are definitely going places. It's important to remember when handling evidence to wear gloves. Me and my fellow agents' gloves were extremely transparent, so now I'm wearing very exaggerated versions to make the point. Let me properly package this evidence. Alright. Well, now that both of our note and our fingerprint is very properly secured, I'm going to sign off on them to make sure the chain of custody is secure.
Let's get all this evidence back to headquarters.
We better hurry. This microwave is ticking, and I don't think it's just popcorn.
Good thing I took such a good note, because now the crime scene is ruined.
Alright, so let's go over what we found. Our first evidence was the blood spatter. It's pattern evidence, and its source was possibly Miss Neff, since she was in the approximate location of where the spatter came from. Its location was on the northern wall of the crime scene, as dictated by our crime scene sketch. What can we learn from this?
Being how it was a high-velocity spatter, I've concluded that it was from a gunshot. An autopsy came back, she was shot, point-blank.
Fact?
Yes. And the lab results came back, it was Miss Neff's blood on the wall.
Very interesting. Our second bit of evidence was the fingerprints. Fingerprints are transfer evidence, like we discussed, and they were found on the lab countertop. We have reason to believe that these fingerprints did come from Miss Neff's killer, but we have not identified anyone with them as of yet. What can these fingerprints tell us?
Upon further investigation of the fingerprints, we've concluded that it was from a left hand.
Interesting.
Yes, and when ran through IFS, it came up with no results.
Ugh. Disappointing fact. This is my favorite piece of evidence, the boo note left by the killer. This note was found on Miss Neff's body, and it was handwritten, and this makes it associative evidence, which means we can link someone to that specific handwriting. What else can this note tell us?
The handwriting fee is really irregular.
So that means it'd be easy to match to a certain person.
Yeah, and the ink is really unique.
It's only sold in certain places, which also means that the ink would be easy to track and we could get a location. Now this evidence was really odd. The entire crime scene smelled like roses. I'm sure this isn't natural. It could have come from something that Miss Neff was baking up in her laboratory, but it obviously came from something with a strong scent. Since this scent isn't going to last, it's called a transient evidence. What else can a transient evidence be?
Smoke, odors, and any liquids are all transient evidences.
Because they can all disappear, and that's a fact. This is part of the crime scene itself. Miss Neff's lab bench was all thrown out of order, which shows there was a struggle. This is conditional evidence because it fits with the conditions of the crime. The location was, of course, the counter, and we suspect that the struggle was with the killer. What else can this tell us?
In the way the cups fell, we can determine the angle at which Mrs. Neff was attacked.
Yeah.
And this helps us reconstruct the scene. Fact!
Oh, dang it. As of yet, this is our only possible suspect, Amy Jade Winehouse. Miss Winehouse has been in trouble with the law before, so we have reason to believe that she could strike again. The reason she's our number one suspect is that she was Miss Neff's pre-AP chem student many, many years ago, and everyone knew that she hated Miss Neff. In fact, she still talks about how Miss Neff was awful to her and could not stand her class. This is a possible motive for murder.
Let's go pay Miss Winehouse a visit and see what else we can learn. So, Miss Winehouse, weren't you once Miss Neff's student?
Yeah, I was, unfortunately.
What do you mean by unfortunately?
Well, she was like always bugging me for the littlest things, like not putting my hair up in the lab.
And did that make you mad?
Well, of course it did. I mean, a girl has to worry about her looks 24/7. And plus, those goggles were hideous.
Are there any other reasons you might hold a grudge against her?
Well, her class is where I first discovered cocaine.
Miss Winehouse, Mrs. Neff was found dead, and we have reasons to believe he did it.
Well, if it was me, I wouldn't remember. I mean, rehab took about a third of my memory.
Well, then your testimony evidence won't be very good in court. But perhaps this will jog your memory.
Guys, break it up. This is bad science.
Miss Winehouse, does this look like your handwriting?
No, but I can tell you whose it is. So you see, there's this gang called the Bad Boys with a Z. You know, like the song. Mm-hmm.
Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you, bad boys, bad boys?
Yeah, they leave a boo note at every killing they do.
So, it's their MO.
Yeah, but you know, catching one of those guys isn't easy. I mean, they have special powers. You're gonna need a special kind of person to find one.
I've got just the person. McGruff the crime dog. His nose could find anything.
Yeah, well, he's still in trouble for that race incident.
Yes, but who can we get?
We can call in the dragon. Dragon's magical power will get the bad boys in no time.
Perfect.
You summoned me.
Dragon, we need you to identify the bad boy that wrote this note.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We got some work to do now.
Hey, No, that's okay. I'll be there. Okay. I'm gonna have to call you back. It's been a long time.
Ever had, make it all better when I'm feeling sad. Tell me that I'm special even when I know I'm not.
You know I love you, baby. No, I love you more. I love you more. No, I love you more. No, really, listen, I love you a lot. You're so... I can explain everything. No!
My God. The kid.
Agent A, this is very important. Did you witness anything else when you saw the bad boy die?
Well, he did say something.
And that was?
Well, first he said he was hired.
Okay.
And then, as he was falling to his death, he said that she was beautiful.
Well, then, why don't we look for the most beautiful woman in the world?
And let's use the most reliable search engine in the world. Google.
Fact.
Oh, I found it.
What is?
The most beautiful woman in the world is Señorita Rosita Bonita.
Well, how about we pay Miss Bonita a visit? To the mystery machine!
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We got some work to do now.
I came as quick as I could. Oh, this whole place smells like roses. You didn't miss anything. Señorita Rosita Bonita isn't home yet. In fact, I just think I heard her now.
You're way too beautiful, girl. That's why it'll never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over.
Hola, I am Señorita Rosita Bonita. Can I help you?
Ma'am, we are crime scene investigators, and we'd like to ask you a few questions, if that's all right.
Of course. I love talking about myself.
Well, I'm going to take this down, because this is good testimonial evidence. Miss Bonita, did you know Miss Neff?
No. I have never heard that name in my entire life.
Well, you see, she was developing a beauty serum. Seems like a person like yourself would want something like that.
Why would I need that formula? I'm hotter than lead.
Oh my gosh, I've got a gun.
Senorita Spot.
Butler. You're on the news ranting about how bad she is.
She is bad. She fired me, so I went around committing crimes that I knew she could get framed for.
Please place your finger here so I can identify you. Okay, you can remove your finger now. It's now going to scan your fingerprint and compare it to thousands of other convicted felons in the system. It's comparing. Looks like we found a match. You are Jeffrey Vandegraaff.
That's why the crime scene smelled like roses. You were there the whole time.
Yeah, and I would have gotten away with it too, if it weren't for you meddling kids.
Another job well done.
So, what have we learned today?
To not work for crazy supermodels, you end up cross-dressing and breaking the law.
You know, silly. When things are done right, forensic science can solve any kind of crime.
Very good, Agent Q. You're going places. Now, let us have a moment of silence for the best forensic science teacher ever, Miss Amy Neff. You will be missed. And that's a fact.
Give me more loving than I've ever had. Make it all better when I'm feeling sad. Tell me that I'm special even when I know I'm not. Make it feel good when it hurts so bad. Barely getting mad, I'm so glad I found you. I love being around you. You make it easy. It's easy as one, two, one, two. There's three, only four. One thing to do. Three words for you.